Is that it?
Aftershocks, maybe?
Been coming here since I was a kid. Never heard of any earthquakes.
I've never been in an earthquake. How strong do you think it was?
On the Richter scale? No idea. Seemed pretty weak. What the fuck?
I think the lake is draining.
There are supposed to be all sorts of caves down there. But the earthquake opened one up.
Unless, do you think this is one of those giant supervolcanoes like in Yellowstone?
That seems unlikely. I hope not.
Yeah, because that would suck.
Totally. This is awesome.
You can still go swimming if you're hot.
In the supervolcano lake? Mm-hmm. What did you feel?
We should get the hell out of here.
Yeah. This is nuts. How is this happening?
I'm not sure yet. Certainly, I'm not sure. Maybe we missed something. What happened to your head?
Oh, when we were fixing the...
Paige is pissed.
Paige is always pissed. Sorry.
What should we be pissed about anyway? It's not like it's our fault.
No, but seriously, this isn't one of our normal...
Alright, no. Paige, last week I suggested to her that she could let the board know that we were 95% sure we'd be approving CO2 sequestration Site B.
Well, the timing kind of sucks. There's like, what, 0% chance now?
I know. Paige rang only a few seconds after the quake started.
Oh yeah? How's she taking it?
Well, you can find out for yourself. Our conversation was cut off almost immediately. Landlines were knocked out. And of course that mobile she's always nursing doesn't work in the valley, so I'd wager she's already on her way here now.
Okay, Paige's feelings on this whole thing aside, Alan, what's going on?
Right, No, we've been able to get a rough idea of the epicenter, and it seems to be one of the dormant, or not-so-dormant, fault lines under Lake Cavernous. Lauren confirmed that the underwater caverns there descend deep into the basalt rock we've been studying beneath the lake. And as this imaging suggests, the fault lines seem to pass right through them.
How did this happen? You just said that you were ready to give a green light to Site B being geologically inactive. Who messed up? How can a dormant fault line suddenly reactivate?
I don't know yet, but the first step in finding out is getting you into those caves. Noah, assist Lauren with whatever she needs. And well...
Alan, what the hell is going on? Apparently I made an ass of myself last week telling the board we were in the clear. Do you know how stupid this...
Yeah, Paige, he said 95% sure, not 100.
Nice look, Ethan. I think you should keep it. I am not taking the fall for this. You're getting in my car and driving back and explaining to the board what the hell is going on.
I cannot leave right now.
They're ready to fire all of us.
Okay, Ethan knows about as much as I do at this point. Ethan can go with you.
Whoa, wait a sec, Alan.
Ethan can go with you. He'll explain the status. I need to be here right now.
All right, Ethan, let's go.
Guess they're not going out anymore, huh?
Let's go.
You're going to corporate or the plant?
Everyone's at the plant. They've been there non-stop since last week when I made an ass of myself. So yeah, we're going down to the plant.
So what was the vibe down there after the quake? They're not seriously blaming you, are they? Are they?
Ethan, how about we just get there, okay?
Tanks. Regulators?
Uh-huh. Is there tape and hot batteries in the camera?
Define hot. I'll make sure.
I'll go inside and get the tapes.
Well, we're not going that way. What's the plan now? Look, if we can't make it in, I really need to get back to help out. This is a very critical time
for— Okay. Okay. We have to get there. We're walking.
Is that a request? Guess not. Look, Paige, if we're gonna go down there, you need to know I'm not gonna be sugarcoating this whole thing. This is bad. Active fault lines means no geologic CO2 sequestration.
That's your 3 years field experience talking?
No, Paige, I know about this stuff.
The whole point of carbon sequestration is to keep carbon emissions out of the atmosphere, right? I mean, you capture the CO2 from the smokestacks, combine it with water, and inject it deep into the ground. In this case, we've,
What?
Been searching for basalt rock, which pretty much soaks it up like a sponge.
Gee, even. I guess if I work for a core energy company, I'll know all that.
Paige, I'm just trying—
You always talk down at me.
Okay, I'm sorry. What I'm getting at is they can't bury carbon dioxide in an earthquake zone.
Ethan, it was just one quake, a fluke. Alan said himself those fault lines have been dormant for a millennia.
Hey, I was convinced about the stability of Site A too, and I have no idea how this earthquake occurred. I mean, you can pretty much rule out human causes.
Human causes? For an earthquake?
Well, the injection location at Site A, it's just— it's nowhere near the epicenter in Site B. There really couldn't have been any lubrication.
Lubrication? Ethan, what are you talking about?
Well, there's only been a few cases, but sometimes pumping fluid in the ground seems to have kind of like lubricated fault lines, you know, which of course can cause an earthquake, but
that's just been in cases where the fluid's actually being injected near the fault lines themselves. Not applicable here because Site A, where Brimish is now sequestering, it's nowhere near the epicenter in Site B.
The point, Ethan. What's your point?
The point is, the whole reason for burying carbon dioxide is to keep carbon emissions out of the atmosphere, to slow climate change, right? Well, if this area is geologically active, which it certainly apparently seems to be, there's no guarantee the CO2 wouldn't just leak right back up through fissures or shifting water tables or who knows what else, making the whole burying part pointless. No stable geology, no carbon sequestration.
Yeah, we should get moving.
Why don't you let me take care of that, and you can get into your wetsuit.
Right.
This is practically empty. Noah, you were supposed to fill the tanks last weekend.
I did.
Then why is it empty?
Hello, maybe it leaked out?
God, Noah.
Come on, you hired me to update your computers, and now it's all— Noah, take out the trash. Noah, get the gear. Noah, fill the tanks.
Put it in the back seat this time, that way you won't forget it. Hold on.